Local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
Sky 4 flew over storm damaging Greer today. Trees and power lines down. This is what damage looked like all over the upstate after last night's storm.
And let's take a closer look here. Get right down on the ground there with the flooding and some of those downed trees. And given all this, we're going to begin tonight with Chief Meteorologist John Sesswich, who is live tonight on the road at the Peace Center in downtown Greenville.
John, last night was rocky. Is tonight shaping up as the same?
Oh, thank goodness it's not going to be the same, Carol and Michael. Yeah, the atmosphere is not even close to being so unstable as it was at this time yesterday when we had numerous severe thunderstorms march across the area from northeast to southwest across the area. As you can see on live Super Doppler 4HD, not as many thunderstorms. They're scattered mainly in through North Carolina, through the Piedmont. Just south of you folks in Hickory, there's a severe thunderstorm warning that continues with that cell. Otherwise, no watches and warnings in the thunderstorms in western North Carolina, especially in the western North Carolina counties that border along Tennessee. And those thunderstorms are moving westbound into East Tennessee. I'll be back a little bit later on. Now back to you.
Thank you, John. Some people are going to be without a car for a while. That's because those cars were damaged in last night's storms. News 4's Sean Mazzarello takes us to Club Drive in Greenville, where a string of neighbors are dealing with this very issue.
I literally drove in probably 20 minutes before this happened and parked.
Kristen Sims and her kids were not in her car when this happened. She said she was inside taking a nap. She immediately woke up, though, when she heard a loud bang. A huge tree in her neighbor's yard had fallen.
I mean, it basically looks like it was cut in half.
She's talking about her neighbor's car. The people next door were not at home, Sim said, but both of their cars were crushed. They have young twin boys.
But we're just so thankful nobody was hurt. Nobody was in there and everybody's safe.
Sims waited most of the day to check out the damage inside her car. The branches were covering it. She could tell the front windshield was busted. Small potatoes compared to what could have been, she says.
Sometimes I sit in the car and finish up a conversation on my phone, or I, you know, take care of getting my stuff together and all that stuff. I'm just glad I wasn't sitting in it and my kids were not in there. Very thankful for that.
Sean Mazzarello, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
Well, with all of this recent rain, trees are coming down more often. News 4 meteorologist Chris Justice has more on what you need to know before the next storm arrives. Chris?
Well, Carol, here's a look at live Super Doppler 4 as the storms rolled through last night. John and I estimate that winds in these storms are up to 60 miles per hour. And with more storms on the way, experts have a warning for you when you're both on the road and at home. Cleanup is underway near the News 4 studios. Experts say this massive tree was nearly 150 years old. It came crashing down with yesterday's strong winds, which were abnormally coming out of the northeast. Thankfully, it fell in an empty lot. This fence suffered the brunt of the damage. But had the wind been coming from the normal westerly direction, this enormous tree would have crashed right onto Rutherford Street. And experts have a warning for you. With all of our saturated grounds, trees are coming down much easier and without warning. They say during storms, simply stay off the roads.
Well, it came up suddenly, and as you can look around and see all the debris all over the ground, you can tell the wind was very high.
Today is a day of cleanup for many around the area, but before the next storm arrives, you need to look around your house. It used to be older, dried-out trees were the concern, but experts say with saturated grounds, even healthy trees are being uprooted.
If you're just afraid, call a consulting arborist and have him do a hazard evaluation on your tree so that you can feel safe. And if there are any problems, defects, they can be corrected.
Look for any trees that aren't showing healthy leaves. These need to come down as soon as possible. Also, look for towering large trees. If you think your house could be touched, you should call an arborist out to check things over. Now, while assessing your home, look for the safest place away from any of those large trees. When storms arrive, stay on that side of the house.
Quite a night, Chris. Thank you for that. And the heavy rain from last night's storms filled up a Spartanburg street so fast, a couple of cars literally ended up underwater. We mean way under. This happened on Pearl Street near Spartanburg Regional last night. The drivers say the rain was coming down so hard they simply couldn't tell the water was this deep ahead. Matthew Millwood's wife was driving their Mustang. He was in the passenger seat. He says he got out, tried to push the car out, but the water was already too high. Water got into the car and destroyed it.
It was all the way up to my waist, so it was insane. It made me think about the New Orleans people. It just made me think about how crazy that could have been for them. So yeah, you don't see nothing or think nothing about that around here.
was a mess. Now, the people in both cars got out. Everybody's fine. But now they're having to deal with rental cars and insurance, and they are not alone. Police tell us they got several calls from drivers stuck last night in high water.
Last night's storms caused a lot of problems for the Franklin County Sheriff's Office in Georgia. Deputies tell us lightning hit the sheriff's office last night. Captain Gary Smith told us it blew up the phone a dispatcher was using at the time and fried the computer and phone systems. Captain Smith also says they lost their ability to operate cell doors and had to revert back to a key system to keep inmates locked up. We're told the maintenance crews worked quickly and were able to have most things back up and running by 4:30 in the morning. He says they are waiting for phone equipment and computers to be replaced by Windstream.
And this weather has caused some mudslides. Check this out. Because of it, in North Carolina, the Department of Transportation has closed Highway 194 tonight. Here's a look for you. This happened in Avery County. This is near Newland Monday night. We'll give you a moment to take all that in. Look at that. The road is simply gone. This destroyed a couple of mobile homes, several cars. We're told at least one family is displaced because of this mudslide. Crews are working right now trying to determine what's needed to rebuild the road and the nearby slope.
Now, during last night's storms, you all grabbed your cameras and uploaded dozens and dozens of pictures. We'd like to show you some of them right now. These came from folks from all over, from Georgia, from Western North Carolina, from upstate South Carolina. We would love to see your pictures if you have any of these that you would share with us through ULocal. Show us what the storms did in your neighborhood. Upload your pictures or video to ULocal, and you first have to log on to WYFF4.com.